Let's first look at a beautiful set of posters. They include various types: product posters, portraits, magazine covers, movie posters, and even animated characters. This group of posters was generated using a new model, which we call Ovis Image. Ovis Image and Z, Image share a deep connection because both originate from the Alibaba team. Moreover, they both belong to the category of very small models. If you look at the parameters of this model, it only has 7 billion, which is essentially on par with the 6 billion parameter Z image. Some might ask why one team would develop two similar models. In fact, their application focus is different. We can glean some information from the Ovis Image GitHub page. What is the focus of this model? It is text rendering. It can generate all kinds of complex text. Therefore, the focus areas of the two models are different. In this video, we will focus on how to use Ovis Image to generate images with complex text. Currently, the official ComfyUI already supports this model. We can open the ComfyUI commit list. We see a piece of information here that the Ovis Image model has been implemented. Therefore, everyone needs to update their ComfyUI to the latest version. You can also download the corresponding models through the ComfyUI Hugging Face repository address. The model mainly consists of two parts. The first part is the main model, the diffusion model. There is only the original BF16 model and its size is 14 gigabytes. Additionally, there is a text encoder and its size is also quite large at 5.14 gigabytes. Next, we will briefly analyze the technology used by Ovis Image. Through so many new models, you might realize that the current approach for so-called efficient models is mainly to replace the encoder and do a lot of work on the encoder. You will find that whether it is Zeti Image or Ovis Image, which we are discussing today, or even the Flux 2 we mentioned before, their encoders are very large. The Ovis Image workflow can be generally represented as follows. The user's input will go through the text encoder. But this text encoder is what we call Ovis 2.5, which is a specially optimized multimodal model. The biggest feature of this model is its extremely strong ability to ensure the alignment of text and images. Then, it proceeds to the diffusion transformer part. And finally, after decoding, we get the generated image. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can visit this platform through Running Hub in the ComfyUI domain. Running Hub is an excellent online workbench because whenever a new model or new technology appears, they follow up immediately. You can register for Running Hub through the invitation link in my video description and receive 1,000 free credits. Furthermore, logging into Running Hub every day gives you 100 free points, allowing you to try out your own workflows. Now, let's look at this workflow. Structurally, this workflow is no different from the Z image workflow. You just need to replace the loaded models accordingly. First, let's start with the main model loading. I am currently loading the Ovis Image BF16 model. The encoder is, of course, dedicated to this model, but the VAE is the Flux VAE, which is universal, below. We can set the resolution. I set it to 1024 by 1536 because this makes it look more like a poster, which is better. This is the positive prompt section. We can leave the negative prompt empty. For sampling, we set CFG to 5.0, the Euler sampler, and the simple scheduler. I set the sampling steps to 50. Let's first look at the generated image. This is a Disney family portrait. You can see that almost all Disney characters are here. The effect of the generated poster is excellent. Notice the background blur and the text rendering. This is something other models may not be able to achieve. Next, let's test this model's ability to generate general images. For ease of testing, I am now loading a QWM model. We load an image here. For the preset prompt, we want to generate a text-to-image prompt. We will set the token size slightly smaller, setting it to 128 below. We connect the generated output to our positive prompt section. Let's run it directly. The sampling is complete. Let's look at the generated result. Everyone can see that the effect is still very good, including the overall details and the text rendering, which is very precise. The first issue you need to pay attention to here is the steps. In many cases, using 20 steps is okay if there are only characters. However, if you need to render complex text, 20 steps is not enough. For example, let's change this to 20 and feel the difference. Take a look. This is the result with 20 steps. When there is complex text, firstly, it is not clear. And secondly, issues like distorted composition occur. Therefore, we recommend using 50 steps for sampling. Since the official ComfyUI has not provided a sample workflow, the workflow we are currently looking at is basically in this form. Based on my testing, I suggest everyone still use 50 steps for sampling here. We can test another one. This is a girl playing the guitar. Let's try to replicate this image. Looking at the generated image, the generation quality is actually not better than Z image. Therefore, its focus is not on general image generation. Its focus is on generating complex text. Below, I will demonstrate using it to generate various posters. At this point, we won't use QWL. I will write a prompt here. Note that this prompt is very complex. It is a movie poster, specifically a Chinese martial arts movie poster. Take a look. The quality of the generated poster is very high. Look at the overall composition and the text layout. This is much better than posters generated by other models. Let's test another one. This is a diamond necklace poster. You can see that the generated quality is also very high. The key point is that to generate posters like these, we need relatively complex prompts here. We need to point out that because the text encoder's ability is very strong, you do not need to follow a fixed format when writing the prompt. You just need to clearly explain the composition. Of course, this prompt was not written by us. I have a prompt template here. This prompt template is specifically used to generate posters. If we want to describe this poster, we generally have five dimensions. The first is the entire content of the poster. The second is about its style. The third is the text on the poster. The fourth is the style and position of the text. The fifth is the layout. You can use a large language model with this prompt template to help you generate the prompt. For example, if we use Gemini 3.0, you can go to Google's AI Studio and in the model selection list, choose Gemini 3.0 Pro. Then, in the system instruction, paste our prompt template. Below, you can write a subject, which is what kind of poster you want to generate. For example, let's generate a Porsche sports car poster. We hope the main elements are a beautiful car and a beautiful woman. You can certainly write other requirements, but I'll keep it simple here. Then, let's look at the generated content. Let's copy this content and put it into our prompt. Now, let's generate it. Look, the quality is also very high, right? Including the Porsche logo, which is quite clear. Let's try another one. For example, let's write Marvel Heroes family portrait. Now we have generated another prompt. Let's copy it and generate it again. Look, these Marvel heroes are displayed very accurately. Although there are two Spider-Men regardless, you will find that its handling of textile, text layout, and overall content design is very professional. Let's generate a product poster, for example. We will generate a red wine poster. The main body can be written as red wine poster, reflecting health, nature, and nobility. Let's copy this prompt. Take a look. Doesn't the generated feeling look very professional? We reflect natural health, and even the noble texture. It incorporates the text that we designed so beautifully. Of course, this prompt template can also be used with QWMVL, but the effect is not as good. I also have a Chinese version of this prompt here. Note, this Chinese version is the same as the English version I just showed you. We will also try a Marvel Heroes family portrait. Take a look at the generated image. The number of characters is significantly fewer. Therefore, for smaller parameter large language models, their ability to generate prompts is weaker. If you want to achieve better results, I recommend using models like Gemini 3.0 Pro to help you generate prompts. This way, the posters you generate will become very beautiful. For models like QWVL4B, you will find that their ability to generate complex posters is slightly inferior. The focus of the Ovis image model is not speed or high general quality. Its specialized strength is generating images with complex text. You need to be very clear about this point. Well, that is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me and become someone who understands AI.